Now, let's turn to growth and development in plants. And of course, growth and development in plants will kick off beginning with the seed on germinating. And the main growth and development phase will always involve, one, the seed germinating, then sprouting into a new plant. To begin, so growth and development in plants. Growth and development in plants. So we've said the first phase is when a seed germinates. So a seed germinates, or a seed first germinates, and you know very well there are two types of seeds. So types of seeds. And types of seeds can actually result depending on the number of cotyledons. Number of cotyledons. And we have one bean seeds, for example. Number two, we have what you call maize seeds. And this can give us the two main categories. These are dicotyledonous seeds, for example. And these are monocotyledonous seeds. So dicotyledonous seeds and monocotyledonous seeds. So we can actually first have growth and development in plants getting discussed. A plant can begin growing or developing when a seed or its seed first germinates. When germinating, it will give rise to this new plant. So we have two main types of seeds. We have those types of seeds associated with that class called class dicotyledonae, and those associated with the class called monocotyledonae. Dicotyledonous seeds or bean seeds have two cotyledons. Monocotyledonous seeds, such as the maize seeds, have one cotyledon. So, two cotyledons. Then two cotyledons, then you have what you call one cotyledon. So dicots have two cotyledons, then monocots have one cotyledon. So two cotyledons, then one more cotyledon. So two cotyledons and one cotyledon. So that will tell you that dicots have one cotyledon. No, dicots have two cotyledons and monocots have one cotyledon. So cotyledons are also called embryo leaves. So you might get surprised and wonder, what are cotyledons? They're also called the embryo leaves. So if someone asks you to give the two main categories of cotyledons, what will you say? You'll talk about dicotyledonous seeds, monocotyledonous seeds, bean seeds, maize seeds. Two cotyledons, one cotyledon. Or two embryo leaves, then one embryo leaf. Now, if you locally look at the structure of a seed, you'll realize that sometimes you need to know that this can be a very good example of our seed. If I can just make this diagram so that you can use it, and you can have this, maybe something like that, then something like this. Yeah, so here we shall have maybe the remains of style. Of style, then we'll have what else can I be able to label? Maybe you can put your attachment with the parent plant. Attachment with the parent plant. Then you have what you call this part is mostly referred to as the scutellum. I'll be able to give the function of the scutellum as we proceed with our discussions. We have just at the bottom here, position of the plumule and the radicle. So at this point, position of the plumule. Then position of the radicle. oxygen of the radical. Okay, very good. So those are some of the parts of a seed. And you know, this is the external part of a maize seed. External parts of a monocot seed. I don't want to be so biased talking about maize only. So external parts of a monocot seed. And maybe if you look at the external parts of a dicot seed, like that of a bean seed, we'll have something like this. I'm not so good at drawing, so don't worry. So you can have the position of the radical. Yeah. You can have maybe the position of the plumule at this point. Yeah. You can have a part here that you can call the hilum. Yeah. Then you can have the outer part called the tester or the seed coat. So you need to get used to these parts and be able to know how they're supposed to be labeled, because sometimes someone can give you a seed in an exam and ask you to name the parts. So please do get that point of knowing how you can be able to name the parts of a seed, because it's very, very important. So I've talked about remains of style. A style is a hollow-like structure or tubular-like structure that is found in a leaf. And close to just the leaf, we have what we call the flower. So we have to actually talk about the remains of style that form part of what you call the stigma as you actually move down to the ovary in a flower. So this means this is the point where the seed had been attached to the structure of the hollow tube, not in the leaf actually, but in the flower. So remains of style can actually get attached to the flower actually, because the style is one of the female parts of a flower, attached to the stigma at the top, then ovary at the bottom. We have the position of the plumule that will actually be able to grow into the first foliage leaves during germination. Position of the radical, where we shall actually be able to form the root. And what we call the scutellum, the attachment to the parent plant. Now the stem, for example, the branch. And this will form what we call the external parts of the monocot seed. Coming back here, we have recorded the position of the plumule that forms the first foliage leaves. We have the position of the radical that gives us the first root, the hilum, where, for example, water and air can enter the seed during germination. And of course, we have what we call the tester or the seed coat. Now, and this, remember, has to get attached to what we call the micropyle. So that you can actually be able to have it being a point where water can enter or air can enter the seed. But preferably, the hilum was where we had the seed getting attached, you see, to the seed stalk or the funicle, you see. But more specifically, it has a micropyle that can allow water and air to enter the what? Into the seed. So the seed coat covers the outer part of the seed, as you can see. It is also called the tester. And it has actually been able to get hardened so that it can be able to actually protect the delicate inner structures of our seed. We've said that a typical seed consists of a seed coat. I think you can be able to see the outer part. And apart from the seed coat, we have the inner part called the embryo. So the seed coat has to occupy the outer part of the seed, and the inner part of the seed is referred to as the embryo. Now, the seed coat is the outer covering, which in most cases is made up of two layers as well. We have the tester to the outermost, and the tegmen as a thin transparent membrane to the outside. So that means you're actually going to talk about a seed coat getting made up of two very important layers. It has a tester as the hard outer part of the seed covering, and then a tegumen as a transparent membranous tissue to the inside. I repeat, the outer covering of a seed is called the seed coat. It is made up of two parts, the tester, the thick and hard outer covering, and the tegumen, the transparent membranous tissue to the inside. Both the two layers will protect the inner parts of the seed from bacteria, fungi, and organisms, which might damage the seed. The seed coat made of tester, the thick outer part, and the membranous transparent tissue. These two ending up protecting the delicate inner structures of the seed.